So the answer is actually both the first and the third are likely to be significantly greater than one half. The second is not. So assuming the keys have as many zeros and ones as the good key router should be designed to have, this is likely to be equal to one half. There's no reason to expect it to be greater than one half any more likely than it would be less than one half. We're XORing two consecutive key bits. The other two are different from one half. And this is what gives us the opportunity and what gave Bletchley Park the insight needed to break the cipher. For the third one, this follows from the structure of the machine. When the S wheels advance, well, this probability is about one half. But when they don't advance, delta S is always zero. So this means that the probability that delta S is zero is significantly greater than one half. And it turns out for the structure of the Lorenz machine, it's about 0.73. And to know that, you'd have to look in more detail at the structure of the M wheels and to know how frequently the S wheels advance. And when they don't advance, we know the result is zero. When they do advance, about half the time, the result will be zero. Getting the first one right required a little more linguistic insight. And the reason this is greater than a half, well, this depends on subsequent message letters. And if adjacent letters in the message are the same, that ensures that delta M is equal to zero. And it turns out that this is a property that many languages have. You can see that English has it. We have repeated letters here. We also have some repeated letters in wheels. So it's more likely than you would expect by just the normal letter distribution for subsequent letters to be identical. And it turns out that this is a property of German, that about 3.3% of digraphs, meaning pairs two adjacent letters, are the same letter. That means the probability that the messages are equal, well, they could be equal for lots of other reasons, but this biases it towards being more likely to be zero than non-zero. And it turns out that that's 0.061 probability for German. Both of these are numbers that you didn't have enough information to guess on your own. You would need to have an analysis of German text to know that this is the probability here. And you would need a lot more details on the M wheels to be able to get that. So don't feel bad if you didn't get this quiz correctly. Although the structure of the machine should have been enough to guess that this was greater than a half. And if you are familiar with German or could guess that it has properties similar to English, you might have been able to get this one as well.